comes to the Salah, making it up particularly, making up Salah, something in which you want to set your mind on doing. It's almost like a debt that you have. You have a debt and you don't want it to keep getting worse. So you start making payments on it. So you find, you know, the most easy, the most perfect time, you know, and you pray. You know, you pray 2 rakahs, another 2 rakahs, you know, and when you go into sujood also, when you go and you put your head into the on the ground prostration, you pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it easy and uplifting for you to put aside any desires that you have of this world, Cyrus. You put that aside and you focus on praying to Him so that you will feel the benefit of the Salah, because the Salah has utmost benefit of the worshipper. The Salah has the kalimatu shahadatu an la ilaha illallah itself. The allegiance to Allah is in the Salah. So that's the reason why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that the difference between the believer and the non-believer is the Salah. The one who does not pray, they cannot believe, because of the fact that the one who prays, okay, if they get the benefit of the Salah, I'm not talking about those that we just talked about in Surah Ma'un. Surah Ma'un, it talks about those who prayed, but their Salah is not, you know, it's not for their heart. It does not improve them. So the benefit of the Islam is in the Salah, because the benefit of Islam is you upholding your oath of allegiance, you upholding your covenant. You understand that? The Shahada, La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, that's the oath of allegiance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the covenant. You know what a covenant is, Mr. I know? You know what a covenant is? What's a covenant? Covenant. Covenant is like an agreement. Okay? A covenant. Like when the prophets, they took a covenant on behalf of their people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay? Our covenant is our agreement with Allah that we don't associate any with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We don't associate any with Allah. No one is as good as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No one has the reward that Allah has. You understand? No one has the power and the might and the capacity that Allah. Allah is far above everyone. You understand that? So that's the covenant that we have with Allah. So when you pray, that covenant, you are fulfilling your part of that covenant. You understand? When you neglect it, you're neglecting your part of the covenant that you have with your maker, that you have with your creator. Can you pay attention, okay? Because it's really important. You know, the discipline itself is very, very, very important. So again, if you pray, you will feel the benefit. Like anything else, like if you go jogging, you're going to feel the benefit of that somewhere, right? If you study for your, you know, your test, you're going to feel the benefit of that. Hopefully in a test, right? Hopefully it's not too late for some people to get the great grades. If they realize it after the test, because they have, you know, hopefully it was just like a, you know, some kind of a prep test. But if you pray 2 rakahs, you know, try to take your time to think about Allah, and then sit after the 2 rakahs and just meditate, okay? Sit and just think about what more you can do to get closer to Allah. What else can I do? Can I say astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, oh Allah, forgive me? Can I do that? Can I say subhanallah, subhanallah? Can I make dhikr? Can I just remember Allah with my tongue? you know, for a little while? Or do I plan on giving something, you know, to some needy person for Allah's reward? Do I plan on doing that? Do I plan on maybe fasting 2 days? Do I plan on reading some Quran, extra time? You know, do I plan on just making the dua supplication? Rabbi zidni ilma, Rabbi zidni ilma, right? And making dua for my parents, Rabbi irhamhuma kama rabbayani saghira. So after you pray, you have to think about that. You know, do I plan on visiting a sick person? Do I plan on doing that? Do I plan on following up on a sick person? There's a lot of sick people today. You know, what token of appreciation can I show to Allah by doing for His creation? You understand? And, you know, getting back up and saying, now it's time to do the other prayers, right? Okay. Ready, Cyrus? For two more rakahs, right? Because you missed a whole day of prayer, buddy. With the exception of Isha. We did Isha, so. Alhamdulillah. What's the situation on our time? I don't know. Check it out for me, please. 8:11. Oh, okay. Yes, we have some time, but not a whole lot. But inshallah, we'll do some more rakahs, right? Hopefully, all the surahs that you guys know. Inshallah. Say yes. Yes, teacher. Yes. There you go. There you go. Mashallah.